untangle one net. Or two even. I got all jumbled up. Okay. All right, so you take one net. This is its stored position. You unwrap it, and it should pop. I think it should pop open. Okay. You kind of tweak it a little bit. Open up the top. Push in the bottom a little bit. Okay, you set it down. You grab a chicken neck. There's a string in the middle. You put the chicken neck in the middle and you tie it and pull tight. Just like you're tying your shoes. Ta-da! Now, that's what you do. At that point, I grabbed my trusty old crawfishing pole, took the net, and everything else was good. And then I bring the net over here to the water.
He's going in after the chicken wings. Oh, here he comes. I better get the last two baited. We're behind the levee. And the Mississippi River's kind of high this year, and so the water table here is high, but this is the levee. Just a frame of reference. It's Marky Bear and his dad go and do that, and Marky Bear and I are staying back here in the shade. He said he thinks Sparky wants to go fish the nets out of the water by himself. I don't think he cares about crawfish. I think he cares about the chicken necks. Say that again.
The first time was a bust. The river water was too clean, too cold. The dogs got to the stick tight. Didn't catch not one crawfish. So we gave up and we're gonna try over here. They're easy to move. You got your little chicken neck in the middle. Flop it over.
I say
open it up. catch it with a stick. You know, a little less video, a little more help, we could get this done in no time.
We only have one stick.
No, but we could have a net untangler.
All right. That being said, click. It said what?
Huh?
It said what?
Big bad wolf.
I said, what'd you say? Say that again.
I said, we be crawfishing again. But if this don't work, whoops, it's gonna go somewhere else. You just gotta peck around till you find them. Once you find them, we can fish for the next 3 days if we wanted to. Mm-hmm. The first time was a big strikeout, bro. The water was too clear and too cold because the river was up. So we'll move to plan two,
a roadside ditch.
Now we wait.
Oh.
Hey, you got one, Pagodi?
I see.
A nice one, too. Make sure he's in there by himself. Pop him in the back. Good job, girlfriend. You caught a crawfish.
What? Back to Levy?
That's what he said, back to Levy. Been there, done that. Didn't work.
Ooh, two of them. Careful, don't get them on my feet.
Well, see, your job.
What?
Your job is to catch the net.
Yeah.
And ooh. Take it. He goes in the
back. Okay, he didn't make it. He's up there.
So, he got all grassy.
Not good.
You want a bottle of crawfish full of grass? That's better.
So that guy hollered at us to go behind the levee?
That's what he did. Back to levee!
But we went back to levee.
Yeah, we're gonna tell you, been there, done that.
This is so bad for these guys. They don't like each other in there. Whoa. Okay, my job is to what?
To catch just like this.
Okay.
And dump them.
In the
bucket.
I'm videotaping.
Okay, when they don't want to let go.
Yeah.
Gotta do it the old fashioned way.
He's looking to pick at you.
Well, sure he is. And that's okay, because you know what? I'm gonna pick at him back. He's kind of small. Look, if we don't boil him, we'll use him for bait. Well,
do you put anything in here to keep him cool?
Look, That was 1, 2, 3. Back to 1 again. You're not helping.
Mm-hmm. Showing the process, I guess.
That's not good. To pick it up in a steady motion so they don't jump out. There we go. We got 3 crawfishes. Which now live in a 5-gallon bucket. Down right there. Alright. One whole crawfish. We'll take this trap elsewhere.
There's an escapee right here.
Yeah, I let him go.
Oh. Will we find his way back to the river? I mean the fire?
Yeah.
With the help of a cage.
Don't you know, crawfish not so.
This is spot number three as we go crawfish.
Sugar cane. Sugar on the hook. The prospects look good because there are crawfish chimneys here. Oh, crawfish chimneys.
All right. Optimistically hoping to do better than one crawfish or trap on the other side. I picked them up.
Overfished.
Maybe so.
Yeah, I see cars back here a lot. Thank you. Yeah. Is it supposed to be cooler? Okay. I'm sitting in the...
We don't have to. We can just stretch them out in the yard, dry them off. We've got enough for us.
Mm-hmm.
Okie dokie. You're videoing a pot of crawfish? Seems like it ought to be a still shot to me. Put a little Cajun magic on top of all that. And we'll call it supper. Ta-da. Show you how I eat these things. I eat them with my hands. Twist the head off, take a ring or two off, and suck. Pop, smash. Heel, suck.
I need to get a close up. Need to get a close up.
Okay, rock it from side to side, and you pull out the tail. Peel a couple rings off, exposing the tail. Suck it in your mouth. Some people like to suck on the heads. Me, I stick my finger in, get the goodie out. The easy way. I won't choke on it. Rock, pinch, peel, suck. Rock, pinch, peel. Get the goodie out. Well, you know what? Fresh seafood? You know where these crawfish were in the morning? In the water we caught them in. Now, I can't come up with nothing funny to end this with. It's just head sucking, tail pinching, delicious. And you know they're fresh? You watch the schedule.